Next on the bench is a mission style clock. Came in, it doesn't work. Hey, we're going to be taking it apart and seeing what we got. Just wanted to show you what it looks like before we take it apart. Interesting number set. First time I've ever seen numbers like that. Obviously time and strike, only two winding arbors. Has a nice sound to it. And because it's mission style, it's a lot of straight lines. And first thing we need to do is to take off the hands. I'm winding it, but nothing's happening. It looks like, and it's also very tight. Look at this, how tight it is. This is not good. On the time side looks like it can wind okay. So let's wind it up to get that spring out of the way so it's easier to get out of the movement. Now, since we can't wind that thing up, in order to remove it, we're going to have to cut it out of there because we're going to need to replace this spring. Most probably it's 3/4 of an inch. That just looks like a 3/4 of an inch spring. 3/4 of an inch being 0.750. Let's see what it really is. Let's go to the old inch part of the caliper. Yeah, 746, 750, same thing. Yeah, this is 3/4 of an inch. Let's see what the strength is, the thickness of the spring. Not the height, but the thickness. It looks to be about 16/16 of an inch. Either that or 14/16. Most probably 16. The most common spring that's out there is 96 inches in length by 3/4 of an inch high and 16.5 thousandths. You can also get the springs overly strong in the 18/16 flavor from Merits or Time Savers. That looks like to be almost a new spring. It's just like the other one. See that nice bluish type color? This could be an Indian spring. I come across a spring like this that needs to be cut out about 1 in every 50 clocks that I do. So that gives you an idea of how often that you'll see it. If you're a hobbyist and just doing one a year, you may never see one. Okay, we got him out. Let's go ahead and start cutting now. The kind of feel out the waters, because when you cut these springs, this one's going to go boing, and you want to make sure that you're not in the way when that happens. There's the first, oop, you didn't see that. That's the first boing. Next boing. You see, every leaf adds power. And all together, it's 8 days worth of power when it's wound. But each one, when they're unwound like this, doesn't have all that much power. This is 2 leaves at one time. Here's a single, 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 single. Careful when you get too close to the inside there. Let's get rid of this guy. We don't need him sticking us. I don't know, that's been on there a while, but the grease is so new, it's still clear. Okay, as I start taking this stuff out, get ready for boings. Yeah, you heard the boing? There we go. Okay. So here we got a spring, and now we have garbage. you know, possibly the spring just got unhooked from the middle. But if I tried to save a $20 spring by sacrificing a $300 to $400 movement, that'd be crazy. So sometimes you just gotta suck it up and sacrifice what makes sense. This spring here is all completely loose now, so now we can take apart the movement. Here's the key. Throw the key in there too. Make it look nice. Okay, now I'm going to show you the rack. I have the rack all filled up with all the components. We have the strike side, everything's right side up. The time side, same thing. I took the cannon tube off of the minute arbor, and they're in there separately, and you point the things down so they drain downwards. You don't want an air pocket to be simulated and causing some kind of a lock. Like I said, it came out of the ultrasonic. The keyless chucks are great because you can grab things very quickly. About 95% of the things you need to grab, a 3/8 chuck would be terrific. There are a couple which are practically impossible to grab with a chuck. I'll show you how to do those by hand. Oh, since I have too much room here to show you, put it inside the Yali Baker or whatever spring winder you like using. And right now, this is a brand new spring. It has to be cleaned first. So make sure that you do these particular steps. Make sure you wear eye protection, gloves if you got them. Well, you really should have them. Let's ram some of this abrasive pad on top of it. This is where the cannon tube runs up against that pinion there. Make sure you remove any kind of little hairs from the Q-tip if they appear. Now you want to look at every one of the teeth on that little gear in the middle, because if it's cracked, it won't be cracked where you think it would be cracked, like at the skinniest part. No, that would make it too easy. Where it cracks is right up. Okay, one of the teeth. So let's go ahead and put it together and run it without oil and see what exactly we got here. It's probably going to run perfectly. Make sure that when you put the count wheel on that little scratch mark is facing you, because if we put it on wrong, it'll be counting backwards. New Haven's are different than most. It uses these two wheels here for driving the arrow wheel. It goes on this standoff right here. Should not be resting up against that strike. Here it goes. You see it's starting to move there? Okay, it gets in the way, and it's not touching the wheel, but it's getting in the way of the pin. Right now the pin hit it. It's in warning. And then it drops off that little flag and drops that guy right there. That's the way it's supposed to work. Okay, so we got it timed. That's all it took. The test stand that I use for American movements, kind of a very simple, basic design. I think I got this at Merit's or Time Savers. I also got all of the extra accessories. So you can grab the bottom of the movement in many different ways. An angled one, a little horseshoe type, a flat one. On the one that I'm using right now, I'm using a flat one on the bottom. And I'm using that little finger up on top. Okay, we have it running at 3 o'clock. And it's set at 3 o'clock. Gonna let it run overnight and we'll see how it is tomorrow. The movement's been running beautifully for a couple of days now. And I'm going to install it back into the case. Here we have the case open just like it was before. we'll have to straighten out and install those wires and such. Matter of fact, that little wire to advance the striking, let me get the stand out of the way here. Let's go ahead and put this wire back on so we can get everything positioned correctly. Some of these pendulums, especially this one, the hook itself could actually play around with the beat. And this is a New Haven Mission style clock. And off she goes. Let's close her up. Another clock has brought back to life.